Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to finish chapter 4. So today I would like to talk about World Bank Group and the Bank of International Settlements. So first of all, last time we were dealing with international financial organizations which are focusing on consolidation and avoidance of public default. Today our focus will be different because still we are working or dealing with international financial organizations, but at the same time they are not focusing on macro objectives. Mostly they are focusing on projects, or mostly they have supportive role only. So first of all, World Bank Group. World Bank Group is completely about project financing. That was the reason why they established in the last year of the Second World War, so it was part of the package what was created during the Bretton Woods conference. And at the beginning, as you can see, so World Bank Group has different companies, and the oldest is the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, and obviously it was created for reconstruction and rebuild of the European continent. And after, when they were running out of rebuilding stuff, then they started to focus on middle-income and creditworthy low-income countries only in the 60s or after the 60s. So first of all, it's focusing on loans, but again, so it's project-related. Loans should be in their focus. So when you want to build a highway, a bridge, or rebuild a bridge, or when you want to start some education program, then you can have funding from the World Bank, or sorry, from the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. And also what is really important here, that the World Bank is also it's also owned by the United Nations, and it's a non-profit, so it's like the IMF. And also it provides guarantees, risk management products, and analytical and advisory services. What is different also from the IMF, but similar to the ESM, that the funds are collected from the world's financial market. So they are issuing bonds, practically. And this bond issuance means that all their regardless that they are non-profit bank, but all their projects should be profit-oriented, profitable, so it's not charity, it's not aid what they are providing. So you have to pay back the capital, and also you have to pay interest. Just it supports, it's an additional way of funding a project. So that's why this creditworthy is here, because World Bank Group has other subsidiaries which are focusing on aid products, but this one is not. Financing, financial services in detail. So financing, we can see that yeah, it's market oriented, but the length is also similar to the. So maybe when they created the ESM, they had the inspiration from the World Bank, because, or RBRD, because we can see that the majority of the loan is long term, but LIBOR based. So actually it's a flexible interest rate, and is following the trends of the interest rate. So that's why we can still say that they are trying not to run any kind of interest rate risk. But local currency loans. It's really important that World Bank should develop. And the development is highly crucial in the case or in the terms of the financial markets as well. So it can be a huge trap that, oh, I'm a poor country, so please give me loans. And after that, you get used to this situation that, oh, there is a safe lender, I just can borrow from it, and after that I don't want to develop my own domestic financial markets. So, as a result, first of all, that's the reason that local currency loans are provided. First of all, there will be no currency mismatch. So, for example, if you are taking up or are starting a project in Nigeria, you can use Nigerian Naira as a currency. Also, they are issuing bonds in Nigerian Naira, so they are issuing bonds in local currency, so that's why they can lend it out, like an ordinary bank. And the second thing is, later on it will be mentioned, that they are just providing partial funding. So they always need a local partner, a regional development bank, some local banks, so they were never working alone. In this case also they can support the development of the local fund, financial markets and actors. They should collect and accumulate local savings in domestic currency, because otherwise you just not ruining the economy, but you don't contribute anything. So, yeah. So, sometimes you want to hedge your risk with options, swaps, and so on. Just if there is no counterparty, then still at least you can find a friendly IBRD on the other side. It's also really good because it's like a market making. So if the product is available and people are using it, or so companies or other entities are using it, maybe private entities will establish their own parallel products because they see that there is a demand, and it also supports the supply side. Disaster risk financing, other core issue, because there is a huge B. Okay, so disaster financing. So you know that insurance companies, private insurance companies, cannot have any kind of insurance against disasters, because risk should be calculable, and if there is a disaster, then you can fund it on financial basis. So that's why it's out of question in this case. But disaster risk financing is available at the IBRD. It's again, so if you are going to a fragile state with a fragile climate, so in continental Europe, what we have here, this. But for example, if you are in a hurricane area or other severe weather conditions, then this disaster risk financing can be crucial, because disasters are happening more often than elsewhere. Knowledge services. So they are making reports, they are providing support, they are supporting you when you need to plan your project. So something like this. Second subsidiary is the IDA, the International Development Association. This is what is focusing on aid. So we can see here that poorest countries are the clients, and they are providing interest-free loans and grants. So it's not aid, but aid-ish. So at least you have to pay back the capital. At least the principal should be repaid. You can ask the question that why not aid? But the reason is that actually we can say that the repayment is stretched for absolutely long run with a huge grace period. So even if you are running a social project, so let's make schools. Today you start, you build the schools, then people will learn there, will be educated, maybe you can improve the working conditions and so on. So later on, this generation will grow up, so supposedly 25 years later, your tax incomes will be increasing because of your well-educated or more educated generation. Or, for example, if you are investing to healthcare, then people will die less, so you are not losing manpower as much as before, so you can preserve and improve human capital this way, and it should have an impact on tax incomes. So sooner or later you can repay it. Or if you don't want to repay it, because last time I mentioned that it's also stupid, then you can issue government bonds, because now maybe you are more credible than before. There is the HIPIC initiative. So countries which are in this program, they can have additional funding. Actually, you can learn it from other lectures, so I don't want to interfere with this case. But mostly they are focusing on these countries, and they can reduce their debt if they are focusing on social infrastructure development programs. There is the International Finance Corporation, IFC. Here we can see that private sector is in their focus, debt and equity financing. So even they can be partially owners of the company. It also can support FDI, it can also support local development projects, and again, it's mobilizing capital. So they are safe partner, actually, in this game. And yeah, it's also this the sole company or organization is fully paid in capital. All the others are at this 25% that I mentioned already yesterday. And yeah, it's triple rated because it's good, and so they are still conservative. There is this problem that how can you be or how can you remain conservative in funding when you are focusing on emerging economies? Yeah, this question is unanswered yet. Eligible projects. So they should be in private sector, technically sound, so well elaborated, and have to be profitable, benefit for the local economy, and be environmentally and socially sound. Yeah. At least the first points will be satisfied, I think. Investing solutions. So here we can see again loans, 7 to 12 years for profit projects, early stage companies, and expansion project. And we can see that all leasing companies can be involved, local banks are obviously syndicated banks, so again they are joining their forces with other banks. In this case you can avoid the issue of huge exposure to one partner, and also you can scatter the risk of lending. Equity finance, structured finance, risk management products, and again local currency funding. So they want to strengthen trade finance. Yeah, trade finance, actually it means that if you want to export something, so you have already an order to export machinery. You have to build up the production line, so you need initial investments. And in this case it's really good to have export loan, because you know that you have the contract, so sooner or later you can repay it from well-known cash flows. Just in this case you can finance yourself on this basis, so it's less riskier for the lender and also for the borrower to have such incentives. Also there is the Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency. It obviously provides services against breach of contract or a general political risk insurance for investors and lenders. It's really good because again it's this is this way you can reduce your partner risk in special territories. And actually, the fees are around 1% of the issued amount in each year, and it can cover up 15 years. And also, there is this International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes, when people can sit down. Mostly, I think, governments and companies and talk before going to court. So, fundraising. I mentioned already that they are issuing bonds. They are obviously triple rated, because why not? And they are issuing on the wholesale market, so it's not available for maturity. We can see that it can be medium or absolutely long term. Yeah, it fits to their objectives, because come on, they are lending long run, so they should have similar structure on the liability side as well. And so they are backed by governments as the owners of the bank. Obviously, in this case, the IBRD behaves like a bank. So when you are suffering losses, or losses will be absorbed from the equity, not from the liabilities, until you are running out of equity type capital. So it means that they are backed by governments. And obviously, if you are in losses, then okay, a bit disturbed by the bee. That's always a good thing, because you can ask for money. Actually, they never needed additional money, so still the capital is 25% of the capital is paid in yet. Then, also in Basel agreement, like in the case, as you were able to learn at the ESM, has no risk weighting, so it's high quality. And as I mentioned already, they have issued bonds in non-core currencies. So Nigerian Naira, Chinese Renminbi, Zambian something, Chilean Peso, Swedish Koruna, and Thai Baht. Yeah, in the case of Swedish Koruna, obviously they are trying to tapping developed liquid markets in local funding, because they can sell it to local investment funds, local pension funds. Also, the same thing is valid for New Zealand dollar. Yeah. Also, they are issuing structured notes and discount notes. It's only in key currencies for short-term funding. Also, they have these sustainable investment products. Several years ago, I checked. It was nice, so as an investor, people can run and buy it. Just the problem is that you don't know that what are the projects or what are the investments behind it. Even I know a guy or lady who tried to analyze it during her PhD, but I don't think it ended well. So yeah, it's really nice to see, just it's completely non-transparent. Is this real sustainability or just on the paper? Prudent financial policy. So they are always so actually their leverage is really low. So every loan is provided or backed by capital. So it's highly conservative. So they are lending under their potential to maintain their high credit rating. And also we can see the syndicated loan borrowing is popular there. Yeah. And I think that's all.